गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट, टुडे वी विल स्टार्ट विद आर क्लासेस. सो फर्स्ट वी विल स्टार्ट विद द फर्स्ट चैप्टर, दैट इज इंट्रोडक्शन टू माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. सो व्हेन इट कम्स टू इकोनॉमिक्स, द इकोनॉमिक्स इज डिवाइडेड इनटू टू, दैट इज माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स एंड मैक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स. व्हेन इट कम टू माइक्रो इकोनॉमिक्स, वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द इंडिविजुअल इकोनॉमी, how the central government will work, how a single person responds, all those things we are going to study under the microeconomics. When it comes to microeconomics, the first problem arises, that is central problem of economy, or we will call it as a basic problem of economy, which and all the basic problem that are faced by a government. So central government means, when it come to India, we will choose our central government by the election. So when it comes to government, what and all the basic that problem that are faced by a government. In that, the first one, what is the meaning of central problem or the centrally planned economy's problem. So why the problem is arises? Because we have unlimited want we have to satisfy with our limited resources. Unlimited want means we will never satisfy with one commodity or one good. As our day passes or as our demand gets satisfied, we will increase our demand. So demand is goes on increasing. So because of scarcity, the problem of choice arises. So what is scarcity? When it comes to demand, the demand is unlimited, but resources are very limited. Example, if you want to drive a car, you want a car, so you purchase it and you are going to drive it. But what is the main thing required for a car? That is petroleum product. When it comes to petroleum product, the petroleum product are very limited. That we will call it as a scarcity. So it is not unlimitedly provided by the government for every citizen. It is having its certain limits. So when it comes to natural resources, basically the natural resources having its own limitations. Petroleum, for what and all purpose we have to use? First of all, we have to use for our basic needs, that is for our vehicles. After that, for which other purpose the petroleum are used? For the agriculture commodity, that is for the truck or to transfer facility, for that the petroleum product are required. For basically for the industrial area, the most of the industries are run on the basis of petroleum product. For our plane, for our jet, other than that we can use for military purposes. For everything the petroleum is required. Now the problem of government is to distribute this unlimited wants with the limited resources. The unlimited wants is demand for the petroleum product. The scarcity or the limitation is petroleum product. So what government have to do? The government have to distribute this petroleum product among the different consumers, that may be for the military purpose, for industrial purpose, for the daily consumer. So in simple word, we can say in economic, the problem of choice making is called economic problem. We have to make a choice to distribute this petroleum product for a certain group of people. The problem of choice making arises because of unlimited want, how to satisfy with limited resources. So we have to satisfy this want with the limited resources, that is with the petroleum product. So which is the basic or the first problem of our economy, that is what to produce. So what to produce, what does it mean? So what to produce means it is on the basis of government. So government have to choose now what they are going to produce. So as the resources are scarce, what goods are to be produced and how much that product should be produced, it is on the basis of government. So it is depend upon the economy, how the lifestyle of the people, what and all the basic requirement of the people. This and all the things are depending upon the what to produce. So government have to make a choice. Choice among what? Producing the consumer product or the industrial product or essential product or luxury goods or agriculture goods or individual goods, health and education or the military services or the basic education or the higher education. Where you will see all these division in the budget system. So what the government will do in budget system, whatever the income that is government getting, so what it will do, it will divide among the different sector. Which sector is required more money, it will spend more money in that particular sector. Now you can see, because of the virus, now the money, most of the money is spent in the healthcare sector. Now education is not important, military is not important, the important is healthcare. So what to produce, in that the government basically it will tell which sector we have to go for more investment. Now no one is interested to buy the gold or buy the luxury item like cars, furnitures or the TV or electronic items. They are more concerned about the healthcare. Now government is spending more money on healthcare, or the we will call it as a civilian, civil duty, those are doing police work, military work, for them the government is spending more money. So that will come under the what to produce, which commodity you have to produce for the people. So next comes how to produce. In how to produce, there are two kinds of things, that is technology, another one is labors. So technology we will call it as a capital intensive. Capital intensive because in technology we required more and more money. If you want to purchase a machinery, or if you want to develop a machinery, you need a scientist, which is required more money. Innovation, investment is required. So it is divided into two types, that is capital intensive and labor intensive. So labor intensive means you are using more and more amount of labor for the purpose of production. So when it comes to India, we don't have much money in our hand, but we have a sufficient labor in our country. So what we will do, we will reduce our capital investment and we will increase our labor for the production purpose. When it comes to European country, they are having less amount of labor, but amount of capital is high, they are having much money. So what they will do, they will use developed machinery or more amount of technology. And the last concept is for whom to produce, for which people or which category people we should produce the goods and services. So the question leads to the problem of distribution. Distributing what? The goods and services. So for whom we have to distribute these goods? Among the weaker section or the rich group of people? For whom we have to produce the goods and services? Luxury item also are the important. We have to produce the electronic item, sofa sets, all the luxury item, and the same time we have to produce the basic necessary goods, that is food, cloth, shelter. Now it is a problem for us, which kind of goods or services or which kind of goods among whom we have to distribute, whether it is among the richer section or we have to give it for the rich people. Who gets more and who gets less? That is the problem of now economy, to distribute the goods and services, for whom we have to produce these goods and for whom we have to distribute these goods. So if you are going to produce, how much goods we are going to produce and among whom we are going to distribute, this we will study under the third question, that is for whom we should produce the goods and services. So basically we are going to study the basic problem of economy. So now there are three basic problems. So I said what to produce, or what quantity we have to produce, for how to produce, and for whom to produce. So these three concepts which is covered under the basic problem of economy. So the basic problem of economy, nothing but choosing the commodity or distributing the scarce resources among the people. So scarce resources means which are less in the number. So the less number resources we have to distribute among the people. So this is the basic problem of economy and the central problem of economy. So nothing but using this limited resources with unlimited wants. So how to satisfy with the limited resources the unlimited wants? This we will study under this three problem of economy, that is what to produce, how to produce, and for whom these goods and services should be produced. Thank you.